Hello, welcome back to Banner Saga. We are screwed? Okay. This first that guy. So I can go over, we go over here. And let me just again. Call the week. Strength and HP. You know what? No. I think I... No, you, because you would attack him. So call the look. I didn't plan this well enough. You could kill one of those. I think you will. I'll try. Or else just try to weaken it. How does it work? You could move over here. Wait, so he can over here. So he can hit all of them. Those guys. What the heck? Use the time first and doesn't matter. And we could kill them. Nope, we were close. Oh, and he's can hit that guy. Okay. Fair enough. This is the one. Yeah, so you will kill him. Do that thing again. Which one is this? This is the one, so keep insulting him. Oh, it just deals 8 damage, so no matter how much. Where is it? Oh, we can already hit him. I like that. Again. Why does the thing move? Oh, it's dead. Okay. Please come home. You grab a raven running by you. I will have every one of our fighters ready to move. Now, set up walls inside these gates and for them to wait for me. The fighter knows and takes off to find everyone. Where's that fan, Valka? Maybe up on the wall? The fan Valka is here. Valka Zephyr, I've never heard you speak like that. The sudden appearance of the two men surprised you. You were outside the walls. What did you see? The red scouts. A witcher marks as there is an army of them coming this way. The young Mendo's eyes go wide as he stares at Claw and Fang. And if that's true, they'll level this place. The storm must have hidden their approach. Or kept them at bay. But why are they here? Why now? I don't care. We're heading for the mountains. The ravens could take all this dredge, especially with the Valka's help. Like that time in River Rake when you helped Valka Fjorin. I forgot about that. Nyko's eyes light up. If it was Fjorin and a handful of ravens striking down the bandit who called himself the Drawer of Vanger, the river blares across the town, the army of dredge is suspected is real. Mikas, Fangundo, Gudmundr have his guards try to calm the people, but bring him to meet us at the barn with the cart. The young man follows orders without question, not about quality. The cart's not your business. I disagree. A dead Valka gives you a cart to hide in the deepest recesses of our river, and suddenly an army of dredge appears. If you haven't already tried, I doubt you'll be able to open the cart. If it's woven shut as a spec, I'm the only one here who can open it. We told you Juno's not dead. We were just traveling with her. Let me tell you something that compromises my position as Valka. The Juno who I knew, who the entire council knew, was put to death by us, their council. You killed one of your own? It's a very rare sentence reserved only for the worst offenses. Altering people's minds, their faults is one such offense. Polka gets quiet and looks at you. She tried something on me. It didn't really work. Because it wasn't Juno. It couldn't be. Could it? Whoever it was got mercenaries to bring that card here for free. Sato. Regardless, Juno was put to death and Aelin was imprisoned. In his grief, he escaped and stole away with Juno's body. But for what purpose is anyone's guess? So no. You will not be paid by the council for a drop issue by a Valka whose life we ended. Your irritation is rising when another war horn sounds. Two horns means a large force approaches. Collect what you need and hurry to the barn. It's time we discover why you're really here. The last dread falls and you pause, taking heavy breaths. The snow is finally abating. The storm is moving south. Let's get inside the gates, said. We'll do that. Plus free to all talents. Yep. Yep. I'm gonna fucking betrayal, so. Okay, we still we don't have heals, right? So all we can do is this. Plus free break talents, plus armor, and plus to break. You don't really have anyone who can shoot, so I don't think this. That would be beautiful scar. The smell of hay and the ox dung is heavy as you enter the stout wooden bar. Zerf and Nikos are talking in hushed tones to the guard captain, Gudmundur, who glances at the large guard nervously. Everyone knows why we are here, she says. I do not believe in coincidences, but I cannot begin to imagine what would draw an army of dredge to bind up beside the contents of this card. She moves her spear in intricate motions, occasionally shaking her head and starting over. Finally, she looks at you to open it. The sight of the Sundr Bellower's body in the cart silences everyone but you. You howl as the memory of a dream tears through your mind and drops you to your knee. A strange tower of white stone, lightning, fear, confusion, distrust. There is a wrongness about it all. Walter, hey! Walker's voice draws you from the dream and she's shaking you by the straps of the cloak. Everyone is watching. Another dream? She asks the archfiend and focuses on hers. A white stone tower, lightning.
What are you talking about?
Zerf asks, pulling away from the cart. Her tone is full of concern. I saw a tower, lightning. I don't know what I saw. The Volker was shrugging.
That is unexpected,
Zerf says. The Volker looks unaccustomed to spices. Gundumdr, continue your task. Nikos, take some fighters and open the mine. Keep that path clear at all costs. As both men begin to leave, she points up to the cart and shouts, not a word of this. They nod on their way out. She turns to you and Volker.
This card. I'm not sure why they are attacking, but if they try to recapture Bellower...
He's dead. Who cares if they take him?
He cannot die. His immortality is more than rumor. Dredge leaves have no natural end, but they can be killed. All except the immortal Sundr Bellower. They live forever?
Zef knows but looks lost in thought. How do you know all of this? Zef sighs.
The Valkyr know many things about all life in the world. I cannot go into further detail right now.
Further detail? That was no detail at all.
There is an army of dredge coming for this card. I'll tell you more when it is safe. The storm to the south and dredge army to the north leaves us with one way out. The mines.
Wait, a way out is to sit in a hole in the ground?
The Valka have pathways there that will grant us escape, but with all of these people it will be difficult.
Why should I trust anything you say?
How would lies serve me in this moment? If the situation wasn't dire, why would I reveal secrets guarded by the council?
She does seem more open than any Valka or Mender you have ever met.
If we go with you, what is required?
We have a couple of hours to move food and people to the mine. I'll be at the opening preparing the way. Help load carts near the gates or warn the families in the houses of our immediate departure. Without warning, for a response, Zef hurries away.
You know, we could always take Bellower's cart and make a break into the mountains.
It will be reseal Bellower's cart.
Of course, a town in chaos is tempting, makes you wonder what we might find in the Great Hall.
We'll stick with the Valka, for now.
Okay, but a couple of hours won't let us do anything. Time to pick up poison.
It will be head to the Raven's Post. Go over the houses.
Houses.
Roughly half the ravens are around to help me wind through the paths between the old cleaning houses. To the mines, you shout, banging on doors. Families stumble out their homes, asking no questions of you, and head to the mines. After a few paths are cleared, all he whistles to get your attention. Big house over here, says Green. Might be worth checking out. See anything through the windows? Looks empty except for a woman who likes her drink as much as me. She's passed out, realizing her existence in the garage, she said. It's our job to save her. All the laughs and agrees. Old for house, you say, noticing the signs. You bang on the owner door as a precaution. Nothing. Entering, you find scattered toys and hand-carved runes on the wooden blocks. Slumped in a chair and snoring is a middle-aged woman. Doubt you mind, says Ollie, looking over and prying a wine skin from his hand. Papa? Ollie throws an axe at a small girl picks around a wall. She's wiping her ears. What is this? You ask. Ollie tucks away his weapons and looks around the wall. It's like a barn for children, he says. They're all back there sleeping. Don't have missed the mines without us. Chaos at the mine entrance holds your arrival. Bolvar products with a drunk woman over one shoulder and a dozen children in tow, all concept says. And they say the gods are dead. The villagers laugh while frantic mothers scoop up their children. The celebrations end when a loud slam on the gates announces the arrival of the dredge. Everyone into the mine now, Sean says. The mine shaft is cramped and more than once your broken horns knock against the rough ceiling of Aura Timber, through Volca Zephyr at the head of the caravan. She is lighting one of many back-end torches along the way when shouts from the mouth of the man reach you. Dredge! The gate and the town did nothing to hold that bandit. Advance. Grimdomr and his men will slow them, Zephyr says. But it may not be enough. They have orders to collapse the opening if they're overwhelmed. Will keep them from being overwhelmed? Ravens, back to the top. Heading up the mine shaft is like swimming against the current. Frightened villagers push forward and you barely have room to get past the yokes in the car. Quantum in his grim manner looks pleased to see you. No real plan, he says. Just kill as many as you can. The ravens arrive to smell at his words and begin to chant. Sigrun for sure. Oh, we'll take Sephiroth. Maybe Volca? And Bersi? Krumr, I mean. But we won't take Bersi. Let's be on you. Maybe this, and maybe that. And do you have anything interesting? Okay. We did shoot up to level 8, not 10. Okay. I have one of those already. How about you? You're in the break in this. Okay. No, you lack one death, one kill. I'm thinking maybe I'm going to shoot. Yeah, pretty much. Nothing, not too much we can do. She only is level 6. Actually, give him a good chance. Yeah. It's not a gloomy thing, standing here, I guess. I need you, Elsa, and I need you. Amazingly, I won't shoot all of her. Okay. Running Gale. And Mant. Okay. Why do you have to? I don't like that. And he's gone. Mm-hmm.
this for me first. He's ready to die, so. Skipping time. Let's see. Ooh, 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 ooh. That's bad. That's bad. Oh, and he's still. Right. I keep forgetting that it makes no difference what I use. If I use more or more. Okay, we need to get him away. I'm not. What does room do? Increase attack. Okay, that was bad. You can't really do anything, so we'll get you closer. Damn it! And he's down. Oh no, not yet. Surprising. Just like that. And again. And we can. Look at that bus. Oh, you can pull. They hit themselves. Next. He has one more. I think he's a bigger threat. After all. He will never make it. Adjacent enemies. She's down. Or not. That's a lot. Yeah, those are cool. Cool. What are you doing? What are you doing? I don't like it. I like how he kills basically everyone. Oh my god, no. Oh no. Thank you. Fall back! Grootmonder, please. The opening is ready to come down! As everyone sprints into the mine, the guard captain tosses you a heavy hammer and points at the timber. You deserve the honor, he says. You turn and look at the grey sky, the snow, window, and the dread opening toward you. With a hefty swing, the timber snaps and rocks begin to fall. You drop the hammer and race down the shaft toward the light of the torches. Ahead, the path comes to a dead end against the smooth surface of a large flat rock. We should camp, Seth says. It may be the last decent sleep these people get for days. I'll need Nichols to assist me in opening the path beyond. But first, you and I should talk. Give me a second. There's nothing for us to do here. That much I remember. New train. Come back with some new. I'm tired of seeing the same old face. Okay, so we've done it. We can miss 2 days. Okay. 1 day. Yeah, pretty much. A few small fires provide a sense of calm for the caravan, though the villagers keep well away from the ravens. There's enough light to see you are no longer in a man-made mine, but a natural cave of sorts. What are we doing down here? Staying alive and keeping Delaware from the dredge. I thought that was obvious. But we keep heading down like we're haunting dwarves. The Voka gives you a ghost of a smile. Until today, no one but a few on the council knew about these tunnels, not even Menders. We didn't create them, but we have used them a great deal over the years to travel far distances quickly. Zerf becomes quiet, awaiting a question. Where do they lead? Practically everywhere. Arboran, Vol, Grofheim, or what's left of it. I'm not sure anyone knows the full extent of these underground paths, but we're about to enter a corridor, one of the main tunnels. So where are we headed? Where would you go knowing you possess the sleeping body of the immortal Sun God General? You want us to drag him to bloody Manahar, don't you? Manahar is the safest place to secure Belawar's body. Whatever drew the Dredge army toward us in Bindal, the council can find a way to stop it. And what about my ravens? So far, helping Valkap is less than a bloodshed coin. And that is why I am talking to you alone now. The corridor will lead us to Manahar in a week's time. See us there safely, and I'll give you a genuine Valka oath. You will be rewarded well enough to never need work again. You look around at the cave walls and back the way you came. We'll go to Manahar. We were heading up there after the Blue River anyway. And that's a very good place to end this part. So for now, thank you very much. Stay alive and see you soon. Bye!